So where's Cody Rhodes right now? He just pulled out a ladder from underneath the ring, so I think I know where. I think we know where this is going. Cody against Sammy Guevara for both TNT titles in a ladder match. It'd be good to see though.
What do you guys want to talk about?
You turn and heel. Please.
I'm reminded from that last match about a man who once sat on a stage just like that, looked in a ring just like this, and he gave one of the most important addresses in the history of our sport. It inspired thousands of rugby wrestlers. It mobilized literally millions of fans. It was the first hint of a revolution. I am talking about CM Punk and the Pipe Bomb.
Everyone knows that promo, the Pipe Bomb promo, back in 2011.
Someone told me to save this promo, but I honestly don't know if I'm going to get the chance, so I'm going to do it now. In that interview, that was the first whiff of a revolution. He laid out a roadmap. He listed things. Things that for him, for somebody like me, were taboo at the time. Things like going to New Japan Pro Wrestling, working with Ring of Honor.
Yeah.
And ultimately, he would talk about teaming with the Young Bucks. As destiny would have it, as fate would have it, he was unable to do those things, but he would join
I don't know what to say right now.
He would eventually wind up here in what Pro Wrestling Illustrated called the comeback of the year. But if we're being honest with one another, and I see all the CM Punk shirts, it is the comeback of the decade. We are all living it. We are all loving
it. Yeah, it is comeback of the decade. Oh, I know what's saying about him, Cody. So,
in the void that CM Punk left behind, somebody did do each and every one of those things. I did them. I carried every ounce of anti-monopoly sentiment on my shoulders. I held every grain of the revolution in my hand, and each and every one of you.
I just want him to be the heel.
Why I won't turn heel? It's because you cheered me when I needed the most. When it says there is more than one royal family in wrestling, I am talking about me and all of us. People talk about the forbidden door.
Oh, the forbidden door.
It's a problem now. It's vernacular. But if you are an industry journalist who covers what we do and you disagree with anything that I say here tonight, you're not a journalist. As this generation likes to say, check the receipts, check the dates before there was a forbidden door. I was the one who built it. Two weeks, and I see that the Young Bucks last week in the opening segment almost started the Wednesday Night Wars all over again. And listen, I know Red Dragon graduated hip toss class with flying colors, but I don't need to see the Bucks beat the developmental more than once.
Oh, come on.
And then my friend, my Trelawney-like friend in Ricky Starks, my real-life friend, gets into a tiff with Jay Lethal. Word to the wise, the lethal injection is the one cutter in the business that people don't kick out of. Avoid, avoid, avoid. And then one of the most talented wrestlers on the planet that you're going to see later, Malakai Black.
Yes, Malakai Black.
The guy who hung two losses on my name, and everybody knows I hate to lose. A man who needed no help, added insult to injury by getting help in the form of just this size and speed and strength. And I know we're not in the business of renaming people like Gunnar McGillibunny or whatever the hell it is. But not just speed and strength, balls. Because if you come to AEW and you call yourself Brody, you've got balls. And I'll let you find out in 8 years what a mistake that was when that kid shows up. But speaking of Brody, speaking of Darby, of Miro, and of the TNT champion, Sammy Guevara. These are men, a lineage, a legacy of champions who taught you what you have been taught against. Everyone had been conditioned for 20 years that any title that doesn't have the word world in it is a secondary belt. But we don't have secondary belts. The only way it's secondary is because right now, there's two. I think it's pretty clear what we do. I know Tony Khan has sent a contract in the mail to Sammy Guevara and myself. Maybe it's not the contract that I wanted. But Sammy, at this point, beach break, two titles, one champion. Boy, Sammy Guevara, what do you say?
That ladder is huge. So, it's a ladder unification match.
On the ladder match, JR, we were saying there can be only one TNT champion.
I hope Sammy wins this one. But it's probably going to be Cody.
For Sammy Guevara. I hope we can announce that before we go off the air here tonight. Damn, I want to see that.